this balance coaching video, we're going to cover setting up a scan and the various options available to you there. Then we'll briefly go over the scanning process. So the first thing we'll want to do is start down here at the library manager. Now, as a balance user, you have the ability to scan for the product libraries you select from the available product lines. In this case, Biotics Research Corp was the product line that was chosen for this balance license. So that's what shows up in the library manager. You can also scan for services, which we've discussed in the previous video. Again, these are virtual items of therapies and modalities that you might offer in your practice or refer your clients to. You can also see that we have 254 of them, 256 of them currently. And just to clarify, this may be the first time you've heard of the term virtual item. All the services, products, and biomarkers in the ZYTO software are virtual items. So when we talk about a service, for example, we're referring to a unique digital representation of the actual service, which has been encoded in the software. Now, services and products are a subset of virtual items that we often refer to as balancers, and biomarkers are a subset of virtual items we often refer to as stressors. So I just want to familiarize you with those terms before going further. You can also see that I have previously moved over 27 services that I want to scan for in the services collection, but it's really easy to add or subtract items. For example, if I wanted to remove acupuncture from this list, I would click on it in the left-hand column and then click remove, and it will remove it from this list. If I want to add something else to the list, I can come over here. You can see that I deselected all 256 items, and then I've come back in here, and in this case, I'll just reselect acupuncture and move it back over using the blue column with the white arrow. Now, one mistake that we see practitioners often make is they'll go ahead and move all 256 items over into the left-hand column. The problem with that is there might be services that you're unfamiliar with that you end up scanning for and might not feel comfortable explaining to your client. So we encourage practitioners to choose services they either offer or that they refer out. Another thing to note is that when you move services over into that left-hand column, they're automatically saved there. That way you don't have to push a button or come back and add them in each time you do a scan. So these services can also be a good opportunity to create cross-referrals for with other practitioners in your area. If you like a service and want to be able to offer that to your client, you can refer them out to those other practitioners, and in return, oftentimes those practitioners will refer their clients back to you. Now, a good coaching tip I'll share with you regards to services is that whatever you scan for is a potential data point that you may want to look into and consider further. As an example, you can see here coffee enema is one of the services that I can scan for. So say a client gets a scan and a lot of virtual items related to liver come up as out of range. And there are products that pop up that they have a biological coherent response to that are good for helping to support the liver. And then if coffee enema also appears as the top service virtual item, you can see how that relates to the other data points you're seeing. So coffee enema becomes a key data point that you may base your recommendations on. Now, the client might never do a coffee enema, but the fact that it popped up in conjunction with other things regarding the liver is a strong indicator. All right, now one of the things that I want to mention here is that you don't have to have all the items in the inventory collection checkmarked in order for them to be scanned. This is a common misconception. Whether or not they're checked or not, anything that's in this left-hand column is going to get scanned when you do the Balance 5.0 bio survey. The next part of the library menus is the inventory collection. I'm going to click on that. And the concept with inventory is to allow you to identify those products that you stock on your shelf and then scan for those items. So if you do stock items from the product companies that you select for your balance license, we would recommend that you identify those products as being a part of your inventory. This makes it possible to only include products you keep in inventory in the bio survey. I'm going to go ahead and click on all biotics products, and I'll go ahead and move all 273 over into the inventory here. And this will appear, I'll show you later when we do an actual bio survey, how this can be of value to you. It's important to remember that moving a group over to your inventory won't add individual items. To add single items, you need to click on the group first to open it, and then move the individual items you want over to your inventory. Again, as with services, when you move products into your inventory, those items are automatically saved. All the items added to your inventory will be scanned whether or not they have a check mark next to them in this column. So you don't have to check anything here to activate it. Another reason you might want to use the inventory collection is to easily identify products on the report that you carry in inventory. Even if you choose to scan for inventory and the entire product line at the same time, the products will only be scanned once, but the report will indicate which categories the items came from. So the inventory collection becomes a great way to quickly identify if a particular item is in your inventory or if it's something you'll need to order because you don't normally stock it on your shelf. And I'll readdress that point in the next video to help bring some more clarity to the concept and show you what it looks like in the report. For now, I went ahead and added the 273 items to the inventory collection as if I kept them all in inventory. So now let's take a look at the Clients tab. I'm going to go ahead and start with the last option, which is Export Clients. This feature allows you to export all of the clients and their information into an Excel spreadsheet. This is especially helpful because you can set the record, the report, to view just clients that you have scanned within a certain date range. Now, that could be your entire client list or just a portion of it, and you might use that list to send out emails or snail mail like special deals, reminders, thank you cards, holiday cards, and so on. So you could also use the Export Clients feature to allow you to export client data for a specific period of time. So say that you went to a health fair over a 2-day time frame. You could actually filter out those clients that you scanned over that 2-day period and send them a follow-up email as a way of trying to increase your client base, for example. So exporting clients using the Export Client feature here allows you to create an Excel spreadsheet so that you can utilize that information in any way that you see fit. So the next option under Clients is Session History. Session History can be beneficial in that you can go in and see how many ZYTO scans you are running in a current day, week, or month. It also allows you to quickly find specific scans. So if you knew that a client came in on Friday the 24th, you could quickly access that client's data. You can also search specifically using a client's name. The next option is the My Client tab. This is where you go to create a new client or to start a session with an existing client. For this demo, I'm going to create a client by clicking on New Client, and I can name the client Sample Client. Now, all the information here can be of value to enter, but only the information highlighted in yellow is required. And this includes the first name, last name, gender. And then you'll probably want to go ahead and enter an email address as well. This will allow you to send the report to the client when the scan is complete. Another recommendation is that you enter a birth date so you can filter out products that are not age appropriate. This is especially important when the client is under the age of 16, as many products are set to be just for adults. Now that you've created a client, you also have the ability to edit the client information. You can also add notes to the client. Now these notes are time-stamped, as you can see, and I can enter a note each time the client returns. So each time they come in, I can refer back to these notes for historical information. There's also the ability to create a new appointment, and you would use this to enter the client's next appointment date, which can be included on the final report. Now on the client profile, you can also archive. Now you can never delete a client, but you can archive a client. Basically, it's out of sight, out of mind. So if I want to remove somebody from my current client list, I click on Archive Manager. I type in the name of that client. I'll go ahead and do myself here. I click on Brian Hancock and click Save. And now if I do a search for Brian Hancock under my active clients, you can see that I'm no longer there. However, if I ever want to unarchive a person, I click on Archive Manager again. You can see here Brian Hancock has been archived. I'm going to deselect that particular checkbox, click Save, and now Brian has become an active client again. All right, going back to our sample client, I can click on New Session to start a bio survey. I'm going to click on the Balance 5.0 bio survey, which first gives me the option to scan for inventory. And I'm going to go ahead and select inventory, and then I'm going to click All Biotics Research Corp products as well. Once you've chosen which products you want to scan for, either inventory only, all products, or both, you can choose to scan for product virtual items that are specific to a purpose. Here you can see all of the different categories that have been set up, like digestive issues and sugar handling. Now, in this case, I'm going to go ahead and choose all to ensure that I scan for all products. If you only choose one of these categories, it will only select the products that are specific to that category. Now, there are many benefits to scanning for all the products. With limited data, a practitioner may decide that somebody is having an issue with their immune system and not realize that maybe it has more to do with digestion and gut health. And so if we just were to scan for the product virtual items for immune system, we might miss out on scanning for products that could be very beneficial in actually building the immune system by building the digestive system. And so in general, my recommendation would be scan for all products, because that allows us to get the body's response to all the virtual items so you can see a more complete and accurate picture from the data. By scanning for an entire product line, we present the body with a comprehensive group of product virtual items that can address various body systems and allow the body to determine what might be a biological priority. And that's the whole purpose of the ZYTO balance system, really, is to ask the body which items it's most coherent with and get those responses from the body to help you make better decisions. I'm going to now click Next here and get the bio survey started. I'm going to go ahead and put my hand on the hand cradle here. Now here you can see that there is a video that plays that will help your client better understand what happens during a ZYTO scan. You can always click on the skip video button, just like I did, if they've watched the video multiple times or if you would rather just skip the video. For the first portion of the ZYTO scan, we're actually doing what's called a range scan. A range scan is a type of baseline scan that identifies how the body is responding to the electrical pulses being introduced through the hand cradle. Now, the technology that we use with the ZYTO hand cradle is galvanic skin response. And the way galvanic skin response works is it tests the conductivity in the skin, similar to a lie detector testing technology. In a lie detector test, they will ask baseline questions that are obviously true about their hair or eye color or their name. So if the client has blonde hair, they will ask the person, is your hair blonde? And they will answer yes. Now they're answering a yes to a question that is a known truth. And so they're getting a response that reflects no stress and can be used as a baseline to which they can compare other responses. And that's similar to what we're doing with the range. We present 35 neutral virtual items to the body, get the body's response to those neutral items, and that's how we determine the range of what's normal for that person at that particular point in time. The next item that are scanned for in the balance are what we call biomarkers. And we have 120 of these for male and 121 for female. And these biomarkers are virtual items representing body systems like organs, teeth, vertebrae, TCM meridians, and EAV points. Now, scanning for those biomarkers simply means that we are presenting digital signatures and seeing how the body responds to each unique signature. The data of each of these biomarkers that we scan for is then put into a report for you to analyze. Next, the balance scans for the product virtual items, which essentially means that we are asking, to what degree does the body have a coherent response to a product? Oftentimes, a larger coherent response is a stronger indicator that the body shows a biological coherence to that product. Remember, we are discussing products and balancers at this point in time. In regards to products and balancers, the larger the positive DR value, the bigger the yes response the body is giving in regards to that virtual item. The larger the negative DR value, the bigger the no response the body is giving in regards to that virtual item. DR stands for deviation ratio and is simply a numerical expression of coherence with a specific virtual item. The last thing to be scanned are the services that you selected and put into your service collection in the library portion of your main menu. As a review, we've scanned for 120 or 121 stressor virtual items, depending on the client's gender. The balancer then scans for balancer virtual items in the form of products and services, and then the biosurvey goes through a balance rescan process. Now, this step in the biosurvey takes the product virtual items that had the highest positive DR, or most coherent response. And then, in order of highest positive DR, the software puts those 8 products in circuit one at a time and rescans the biomarker virtual items that were out of range. In this way, we are identifying which virtual items balance the biomarkers. This is graphically shown on the report in the dynamic profile and the product scan results. The biomarker chart also reflects this information collected during this portion of the scan.